you're driving in St. Pete, you might easily pass this building without giving as much as a second thought. However, for its black community, the 17-year-old building serves as a bastion for literacy and knowledge.
Thank you, sir. Now you said just bring it to the center.
This is Ernie Coney, one of the men responsible for the opening of the JWJ Community Library and also the 9th Annual Literacy Festival.
Okay, I'm president of the Friends of the Johnson Branch Library here in St. Petersburg. We put on this literacy festival for 9 years now. We promote literacy. We are a support group for the library. And by putting on this event, we help to promote the library and literacy at the same time. Try to showcase community, things that are going on in the community in one place. So that's basically what we are. We have a lot of vendors here who have businesses in the community. So we're trying to get people to know that they're there, basically.
One of these vendors is Halima Kensler, who through this festival is able to expand her local health
Since
business.
I do quite a lot of different things, I thought this would be an opportunity for me not only to show my crafts off, but also tell people about the products that I sell that are for health, life-saving products, weight loss products. So,
along with vendors, the Literacy Festival hosts a broad range of activities, such as basketball, rock climbing, and even a puppet show. It's easy to forget that without events like these, the places like the JWJ Library would cease to exist.
They were going to close the library over here for budget cuts, because from their perspective, it wasn't being utilized. Even though people weren't checking out books, they were utilizing the library, but it wasn't showing up on the numbers. Got some petitions signed and everything, marched on City Hall, and they reversed their decision. Okay, then we formed a support group to keep an eye on the library and help promote the library. And we've been going ever since. That's when 1990.